think this quote is so beautiful. Test of our progress is not whether we add more to the abundance of those who have much. It is whether we provide enough for those who are too little. And I think we are wanting on this on a national basis. And just to give you a quick snapshot view of ITC, we have helped to increase the yield of about 5 lakh buffaloes in the country. We have done watershed management in an area of 98,000 hectares. We have done afforestation in an area of 1,25,000 hectares. We have developed close to about 54 human hours of work, of which 50% is women-led. We are perhaps the only company in the world which is water-positive, carbon-positive, solid-waste recycling-positive. And as we stand today, the latest figures are that we are getting 38.5% of our energy from renewable sources. And we have just opened a hotel in Chennai, which has kick-started with renewable energy. Therefore, we are decarbonized, and therefore, we are addressing the climate change from design stage in our future projects. We all know the limitations of CSR. You know, people have a tendency to say, I'll do something in my gaon, I'll make a wall for a school or a toilet for a school. But you're not going deep into it. How does the industry apply a strategic mindset to understand the issues holistically and then bring out models which not only address the areas around their facility, but the pilots are so good that it has pan-Asia presence or pan-global presence. Is that possible? I think it's possible because in India and many parts of Asia, we're not focused too much on social innovation, and the time has now come for that. And we also know that Microsoft's turnover is equivalent to GDP of 60 countries. That's the kind of equity which is there, not only globally, but in India. And Dr. Vibha beautifully articulated the inequity. So I'm not going to labor on this slide. And now some humble initiatives of ITC Hotels. We are novice in this area. But sometimes when you're a novice, you have an opportunity of doing things differently. So we have made a menu on CSR. We have employee volunteerism policy. We encourage our people to give their time on off day if they wish to. We have vocational training program for orphan boys and girls. We have an eco-designing program for teachers because the issues are so large that it cannot be solved just through CSR personal per se. Teachers have to understand, they have to cascade that knowledge to the students, and then little kids will take that knowledge home. It's a Trojan horse strategy because a lot of adults don't know a lot of issues about this subject. And we have covered more than 1,000 schools. 1,000 schools doesn't excite us. So therefore, what we have done is we have made an eco rating for schools, 51-point questionnaire. And any school anywhere in the world can download that tool and make their school green. And it's very, very simple. We also have something called greening of supply chain. We engage with our suppliers and upgrade them in sustainable development. And we have also got an initiative of employing people with disability. And very important, I think sometimes we miss the point. In India, practically every home, there is a domestic help. And a large number of us exploit them. So we have developed a training tool for anybody download from anywhere so that each one teach one. If you upgrade the skills of your domestic help, then ladies who are working in organizations can work more peacefully over there. Otherwise, half the time your mind is at home. He has this domestic help, wash her hands before feeding your daughter or son, etc. And you'll be happy to know that this model has been replicated by many more people and is getting scaled up. These are examples of social innovation. What have we done basically? In my business, our core competency is safety, security, hygiene, diplomacy, and we make good food and deliver good service. How do you impart this knowledge in a diluted form for domestic help? That's all is required. And each one of us can easily do that if we only take the trouble of training. But it doesn't happen in most of the places, and we keep reading horror stories in the newspapers. And if we really do that, the hidden agenda in this is that you and I will perhaps pay them more. So we conducted some training programs across the country. We got some very good insights. We also got insights that in our training program, people did not understand anything. Therefore, we did practical sessions for them because through observation, they learned a lot. Otherwise, there were barriers in communication. And what are good ISR practices? We are encouraging our people to forget CSR. Start with your own own home ecosystem. Ask these questions to yourself. Are you paying fair wages to your domestic help? Do you give them a proper meal? Do you give them annual leave? Doesn't matter if three-tier sleeper ticket. Gratuity when they have worked for you for 10, 12 years. Open a no-frill bank account for them. A lot of people are not aware that just helping them to open an account helps to increase their earning capacity through interest. And we have also embedded two questions in our application form to create scale. So anybody who wants to join our hotel, he has to fill up the last two questions. Have you planted saplings? Yes or no? If yes, how many? And if so, where? And have you done any ISR work? So at a young age, we are entering the perceptual arena of the new person's mind. And we are finding that our people are doing small, small things. And that's how we create scale. And thanks to all this sharing, there's one boy about 4 months back, he opened a no-frill bank account for 200 domestic help in Gurgaon. So somewhere the idea that we have been floating has found favor. And this is our initiative for people with disability. When we started this initiative, we said no sympathy for people with disability, only empathy. Because when you empathize, you do the right thing. And we have this girl on the left, Sujata. She's mobility impaired and she handles our engineering control room. And 2 years back, she's got promoted and now she's the engineer secretary. And the other two, lady and gent, they are both visually impaired and they play piano in the lobby. So we have identified what is the strength of the people with disability and given them those kind of jobs. And then we have put visually impaired people in laundry. The story is very long. I'm going to just run through very quickly. This guy is hearing and speech impaired. He's working reservations. He's only loading the information and helped to increase our income by about 60 lakh in Bangalore, ITC Windsor Manor. And once we got the confidence, we have put these people all over the hotel, including this next slide I'll show you. The boy on the right, he's a hearing and speech impaired boy. His job is to open the door and smile, and he's doing that. And when he's not there, our guests ask us, where is that boy? Where is that boy? And again, visually impaired people playing various kinds of equipment. This is a low-cost solar technology made of cardboard and aluminum foil. Cooks for 4 people. This is the kind of knowledge we have to take to rural India. And there's a better technology. So this is called a solar concentrator. Cooks for 15 people in 45 minutes at a temperature of 150 degrees centigrade. We installed it in our head office in 2000. And we dreamt that one day our hotels will operate with this technology. Nothing happened between 2000 and 2009. But between this period, we shared this knowledge with NGOs, and one NGO took it to Leh Ladakh. In Leh Ladakh, women don't take bath for 6 months because it's minus 30, minus 25. Now women are melting ice in this and having a bath and getting rid of their hygiene problems. And from this, today if you go to ITC Moria, we've installed a 150-ton device which stares at the sun. And now I lead you to a subject called biomimicry, copying nature. Sunflower follows the sun, gives you sunflower oil. Our technology, solar concentrated technology, also follows the sun and displaces 13 liters of diesel per hour. That is biomimicry. And we need to work on the subject. Having employed people with disabilities, we are not very excited with what we have done because the numbers are very small and we have our own limitations. And there are 60 million people with disabilities. So when we were doing this initiative, we found there was no book to refer to. We said, no. Please write a book. So we wrote a 10-page book with 6 pages of picture, 4 pages of write-up, because we know people don't have an appetite to read. And today, all the hotel chains have copied us, and we're very happy because our country is very large, and we need emulatory strategies.